finding other alternatives to run pipes. Just like here in this toilet here. Of course, that's tile, like a marble tile, and we do not want to take that out. So what I'm going to do is come over here into the master bedroom, because that's the master toilet, and I'm going to drill from that side out in where the drywall is. And right here, I'm going, this is the lav sink, bath sink in the master bath. Just giving you an idea what I'm going to have to work with here. This is very, very tight. You can't see it. I can actually barely get the camera and myself in here. So what I'm going to do is, again, this is being creative. Rather than trying to go back in the same spot where the original hot and cold water line to this sink is, I'm going to bring it out another wall, which is the same spot where the tub and shower valve. This panel here, I'll remove it, and you'll be able to see the tub and shower valve. And I do apologize about the light; it's a little too bright. It didn't look that bright with the camera up in here, but coming back editing, I could see that it was a little brighter than I needed it to be. So this is where the tub and shower valve is, and we're going to replace the pipes to that, but we're going to keep that same tub and shower valve. And also in that same wall, I'm going to bring the hot and cold water lines out to the bathroom sink, because trying to go into the wall, as you can see there where the valve is coming out, it's going to be a little too tight to try to get the new plumbing in there. So I'm going to make it as easy as I can on myself. And like I said, you can't really see the spot that I'm in. It's really too tight to do what I really would like to do. So again, this is the getting creative and looking at it and studying it and finding the cavities, meaning the openings to where you can run the pipes without with as little destruction as possible. And back to that toilet I was telling you. We're here in the master bedroom, and that's where I'm going to run the pipe for that toilet up into the attic. And now we're in the hall bath. This is the bathroom sink in the hall. And again, tight spot to work in. But I do have a little more space at least to for the hot and cold on the sink itself. Now the difficult part here is going to be getting to the tub and shower valve. It's really it's I can't even explain how it's so hard to get to this spot. And again, I'm gonna apologize for the light again, because like I said, it didn't look as bright when I was up under here working. But again, coming back to editing, I see that the it's pretty bright. And right here, you can see that's a panel. And once we remove that panel, we'll have access to the tub and shower valve. And again, we don't want to go through the front because it's been tiled already, and we do not want to damage any tile, and we want to do as little destruction as we can. And it makes it very difficult when you have to work like this in these conditions. But you know, sometimes you just have to do what you got to do. Now, you see the part where my hands are going through? That's an opening for the drawer. That's why it's so tight to get into here, because I can only get through this spot. And if you know the open size of a drawer, it's really tight. Okay, now we've got to the point where we can expose the tub and shower valve. See it right there? Okay, now what I'm looking at now is that I'm going to need a little more room to actually get to this tub and shower valve, especially on the right hand side from your viewing. So what I'm going to have to do is I'm going to have to cut some more of this wood and extend the paneling to a bigger opening so that I can get access to make my connections to the tub and shower valve. And what I'm doing here is just kind of feeling around to see what kind of room I have to work with. And that's how I know I don't have the room to do what I need to do. So I'm going to have to make the room to do what I need to do. And also, when you see my hand back there, I was feeling to make sure there was nothing that I was going to cut into that I shouldn't. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this small reciprocating saw, battery operated. This is like one of my number one tools. I love this tool. And since this is wood and it's not easy to cut this drywall, we're going to use this electric saw. Sorry, battery powered. And again, I know there's nothing back there that my saw blade is going to hit to cause any problems or any issues. It's just me getting my hands in there and getting in there to positioning myself to cut this. So, of course, you see now I'm taking the other drawer out at the bottom. Here we go. And the saw blade that I'm using on here is a wood cutting saw blade. They make wood cutting saw blades and metal cutting saw blades for this particular saw. This is a Milwaukee small reciprocating saw, 12 volt. It's very fast and strong. And no, they're not paying me for this. I just love their tools. And that's because it makes it a lot easier for me with these tools. Now, there we go. Now I have a little more access to get to the tub and shower valve. It's gonna work because what I need to do is get in here and use a PEX Wurzbow elbow 90 that I can adapt into the valve, from the valve to the PEX piping. Okay, here we are. This is the same bathroom sink that we just cut the tub and shower valve opening wider. It's just now we're over to the part where we're up under the same cabinet. It's just that we're right up under the sink this time, and we're going to cut out access to run our new pipes from the attic down to here. So we're going to make the opening, so when we feed the new PEX pipe down, we'll be able to pull it out from this end. And another reminder, hot is always on the left, cold is always on the right. If it's not, someone made a mistake, and it happens. But it's just to keep a mental note of that in the future. It may come in handy, I don't know.